Okay, so we've been playing with sums and recurrences, and we are like actually doing like some legit stuff now with this. So you might be familiar with the Quicksort algorithm, which is basically a way of finding if you've got a list of things and you're like blah 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 blah, you pick a random thing, and anything that's less than that you put on this side, and anything's more than that you put on this side, and then you go ahead and resort the remaining two lists by using Quicksort. So you got Quicksort on this one and Quicksort on this one, so you pick a random point. And you go blah blah blah, anything on the left, anything on the right, and then random something, blah blah blah, anything on the left, on the right, and now you have four things that all have to be sorted with quicksort. So it probably comes as no shock that the number of comparisons for a list of some length in quicksort is given by a recursive definition. So here we go. In quicksort, the average number of comparisons is given by, so if I have a length of or of a list of length n, then I can do the number of comparisons for that list by going n plus 1 plus 2 over n. And then there's a summation. Ooh, you're gonna love this. There's a summation with c sub k with a previous term in it. So basically, we're summing all the previous terms every time we go through here. And this is valid for n greater than or equal to 2. Because it doesn't take any comparisons to sort lists of length 1 or 0. So, if you go through here, you can come up with the idea that, well, c sub 0 is 0, c sub 1 is 1. I already wrote that. Let me write it again. I can say that c sub 2, there we go, c sub 2 would be given by 2 plus 1 plus 2 over 2, k going from 0 to 1. Of c sub k. So basically that's 2 plus 1 plus 1 times 0 plus 0, so that's 3. All right, so c sub 2 is 3. All right, let me make that a little bit prettier. Zoop. And there we go. Okay, then we have c sub 3. So I've got 3 plus 1, in case you're wondering where those are coming, so there's my n, right? So n. 3 plus 1 plus 2/3, and then the sum of all the previous c sub k's. So that's going to be 4 plus 2/3 times 0 plus 0 plus 3, and that comes out to 6. And if you do c sub 4, eventually that comes out to 19 over 2. And the book I got this out of says this does nothing to quell our fears. So I'm going to write that down because it makes me super happy to know that even people who write fancy textbooks are afraid sometimes. Quell our fears. It's like whenever Gandalf is like, dude, it's okay. You could be kind of afraid of this guy. It's kind of like a big deal. So, this recurrence with a summation in it is kind of a big deal. So, it's a sum inside a recurrence. Believe it or not, we can do something with this. All right. So, fractions are scary. I don't even think I need to explain that. Fractions are scary. So, let's multiply that whole thing by n. All right, so we're going to end up with, let's see, we're going to end up with n c sub n is equal to n squared plus n plus 2, and I've got the summation k equals 0 to n minus 1 c sub k, and this is good for n greater than or equal to 2. Now, you're just going to feel like this is really dumb, but just bear with me, okay? Now, what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite this in terms of n minus 1, because we're just trying to see if we can see some kind of a pattern. So I've got c n sub n minus 1, c sub n minus 1 is equal to n minus 1 squared plus n minus 1 plus 2 times k equals 0 to n minus 1, which is n minus 2, c sub k. And this is valid for n greater than or equal to 3. So ideally, what we want to do is we would love to combine these. Somehow, because if we can make these match-ish, then like maybe we can cancel them out somehow. So I'm gonna say cancel out sums through fun and profit through. So we got like step one, cancel out, and step two, step three, profit. Okay, so that's where we are right now. We're just trying to come up with something that might accidentally work. Okay, so let's look at this n equals 2 guy. So we're going to take this one over here, and we're just going to try to rewrite that sum with we want the, so they almost match, right? Because this is n minus 1 and this is n minus 2. So let's do ncn is equal to n squared plus n plus 2. Now, what we're going to do, okay, you ready for this? What we're going to do is we're going to pull the n minus 1 term out so that now instead of going from 0 to n minus 1, we're only going to go from 0 to n minus 2 because we've already taken care of the n minus 1 term on its own. Okay, so let's go ahead and rewrite this. We've got n sub cn, n squared, n 2 cn minus 1, and this ugly, 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 what do you call this thing? Summation. So we have this horrible summation. All right, so now let's take this lovely creature. Whoa, that was not green. Let's take this lovely creature, and she really doesn't want to play. But we're gonna make this, it's gonna be amazing. Okay, so just chill. All right, we're gonna subtract that. Okay, so all this thing up here, we are gonna subtract from the thing we just came up with. Okay, got it? Okay, I know it's scary, but it's gonna be okay. All right, so we've got minus n minus 1. Can you see what I'm doing? No. Minus n minus 1, cn minus 1, equals minus, and I'm just going to go ahead and start multiplying some of this out, n squared minus 2n plus 1, minus n minus 1, which will be minus n plus 1, and then minus 2, gotcha, donk, donk, blah, 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 to-doop, doop, doop, and ck. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add these together, okay? So we're going to add these together, and we're going to get something amazing because, well, one thing that's going to happen, you probably already figured this out, is that this term here and this term here are going to cancel out. They're going to cancel out, and it's going to be amazing. Okay, so we have n cn minus, let's go ahead and put all that together, minus n cn minus 1 plus cn minus 1 equals, I'm going to go ahead and make a little bit of happiness here. Okay, so if I'm adding those together, I've got the n squareds are going to cancel out. I have an n plus 2n minus n, so that's going to end me up with a 2n. And then I have a minus 1 plus 1. All right, so those go away, so all I have is the 2 cn minus 1, and then those are all gone. All right, so I have a cn minus 1 and a 2 cn minus 1, so I should be able to do some combinations here. Ncn, n plus 1, cn plus 2n. Now, for the validation of this, we're going to have to stick with n greater than or equal to 3, because this one is the most restrictive. So we're going to have to stick with the most restrictive one, and maybe we'll be able to pull that down later, but for right now. But look what happened. We basically took this horrible, horrible thing, and if nothing else, oh, I forgot my minus one. Ooh, that would have been bad. If nothing else, we rewrote it without a stupid summation and recurrence, so that makes us happy. Now we can go and we can try and write this recurrence as a summation. I'm going to make this prettier now. All right, so we're going to write this recurrence as a summation. Okay, so that'll be fun. All right. Sorry, I had to like pull myself together. I can do this. All right, so in general, our Sn is going to be equal to An minus 1, An minus 2, all the way down to A naught. And we've got Bn, Bn minus 1, all the way down to B1. Which is fine. All right, so let's do this. So I've got this is A, this is A, and this is B. All right, so we're going to have an A n minus 1, so that's n minus 1, n minus 2, n minus 3, and then it's going to come down here, and it's going to be 2, and a 1, and a 0, and then on the bottom it'll be n plus 1, n minus 1, and then it'll come down here, and it'll be a 4, and a 3, and a 2. All right, so that's all well and good, except for this whole 0 thing, because basically what's going to happen is we'll multiply by 0, and then everything will be 0, multiply the whole equation by 0, and it's like, why are we doing this? But the good news is we can actually not go all the way down to A0. We can go to A1 and B2. Because it was kind of arbitrary. Remember, we're just making this up as we go anyway. We're just trying to find something that works. We don't have to be held to the, you know, confines of our ancestors. So anyway, so stuff cancels out. Choop, choop, choop. And these are all going to cancel out with stuff down here. These are going to cancel up with stuff down here. So I'm left with a 2 and an n plus 1. So I've got Sn is going to be equal to 2 times n over n plus 1. So I'm going to multiply that whole equation by n over by 2 over n times n plus 1. And really, I don't have to use the 2. It'll cancel out in a second, but that's okay. We'll do it for the moment. So I have 2n, n plus 1, c sub n, 2, n plus 1, n plus 1, c sub n minus 1, plus 2n. And math is amazing because stuff goes away, and the 2 goes away. Woot. I feel like I'm missing something. Oh, yeah, I'm missing all kinds of stuff. Woo. So what happens when you get excited about math? Your common sense just goes straight out the window. All right, that was zip, doop, doop. And then the n's go away. And then that 4 becomes a 2. Okay, so I have cn with a 1 over n plus 1 out front. And I have a 1 over n with a cn minus 1 and a 2 over n plus 1. Now, what's amazing about this is, again, we're seeing that pattern where if I let sn be equal to 1 over n plus 1 cn, then that means s sub n minus 1 is 1 over n c sub n minus 1. And S naught is going to be equal to, what do you call that thing? Hold on, I can do this. So S naught is going to be given by 1 over 1 C naught. And remember, these are only good for N greater than or equal to 3. So I need to do the first 0, 1, and 2 of these. I wasn't sure I could do that kind of math at the top of my head. So I've got 0, 1, and 2. And these were, so that means S naught, what was this one? The first one was 0, the second one was 0, and the third one, it's hard to say third one and write 2, just so you know. And the third one is 1/3 of 3. And I think that's what we came up with. 3. way over there. 3. All right. 1/3 of 3, so that means the term's going to be 1. Wonderful. See, I said 2 and I wrote 3. Wonderful. All right. So basically now we can rewrite this as S sub n is equal to S sub n minus 1 plus 2 sub n or 2 over n plus 1. So now we can write this as a summation. So we have S naught, S1, S2, and now this is good for anywhere from 3 on up, 2 over k plus 1. So this is super amazing. And if you don't think it's amazing, I don't know. It's because you have no mathematical soul. You have to have soul. You have to love this. This is fantastic. All right. So what am I doing? Oh, I'm doing math. Okay, here we go. All right. So this one is 0. Can't tell, but it is. This one is 0. This one is 0, and this one is 3. 0, 0, and 3. I should do that better, but I'm too lazy. I'm so lazy, I'm recording math videos in my free time. All right, so let's see. We have this k plus 1 thingy, so we're going to adjust to sum. I don't like having a k plus 1 on the bottom, so I'm going to not add 1. I'm going to subtract 1. Come here. I'm going to subtract 1, which means I need to add 1 to both of these, just like I would with an integral or anything like that. So 3 plus the summation k going from 4 to n plus 1 of 2 over k. Now I just have to do a little bit of mathematical manipulation because I do have a formula. Well, not really a formula, but there is a name for something. So I'm looking to get it in the terms of k equals 1 to n of 1 over k. Because that actually is going to be my harmonic sequence, and it's a thing. Okay, it's a thing in that it's not simplifiable, but it has a name, and it's called the harmonic sequence. harmonic sequence. I can't spell quince. There's the harmonic sequence. So basically what I'd like to do is I'd like to get that summation at least looking like a harmonic sequence so that I can take it home to mother. Okay, so I want to have in that summation, I want it to go from 1 to n, which means I need to subtract off. Ooh, hold on. Yeah, I'll do the 2 out the front. Hold on, let's do it this way. Let's put the 2 here. And I want it to go from 1 to n, which means now I have terms 1, 2, and 3 that I don't need. So I have to subtract off terms 1, 2, and 3 that I don't need. But I'm also missing the n plus 1 term, so I need to add that one back on. Okay? And the reason that I would do that is, I mean, it's only going to impress, like I said, my mama. My mama loves harmonic sequences. So I have 2 times the harmonic sequence, and then minus 1, minus a 2, minus a third. All right, so that's, hold on, I can do this kind of math, I swear. I got 6/6 and 3/6 and 2/6. So how many 6 is that? 11/6. Look at me. I can find common denominators. Plus n plus 1. Okay, so summation is going to be 3. And look at me doing math. Math, 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 math. Okay. All right, and then just doing like more math. Oh, wait. Yep, that's what I wanted. So how come none of y'all told me that I did this wrong? This is supposed to be a 3, so I'm gonna change all those to 3s. 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Okay. I mean, 1s. I'm gonna change them all to 1s. All right, there we go. 1s, and we'll call that 3/3. All right. So basically now I have the summation that is going to be equal to negative 8/3 plus 2 over n plus 1 plus twice the harmonic sequence. Again, I'm not done because I'm supposed to have something that's in terms of C sub n. So I've got to go way up here and try to remember what C sub n and S sub n had in common. So there was that, how they're related. So Cn is going to be equal to n plus 1 times Sn. So Cn is going to be able to go to n plus 1 times Sn. And so now it's just a question of plugging that in, which is actually kind of neat because some things, I mean, as you would expect them to, they're going to cancel out in lovely ways. So I've got that C sub n is going to be equal to negative 2/3 n. Plus 8/3 or minus 8/3 plus 2 n plus 1 h sub n, and that's good for n greater than or equal to 3, and that I've got to specifically say that c sub naught and c sub 1 are equal to 0 and c sub 2 is equal to 3. But actually, if I'm super clever, I'll figure out that this actually does work for n equals 2, so I don't have to do that. So now I've got this lovely thing, and you might say, well, that's kind of silly, though, because you still have that weird harmonic sequence I've never heard of, but other people have heard of it. And if you're using, like, MATLAB or some kind of computing software, they're going to have a harmonic sequence function in there, that harmonic number, so they'd actually be able to calculate that out. So again, rather than having to try to figure out, well, how am I going to program, and I know it's just a for loop and a couple of recursions, but rather than having to represent something like this, which I think is pretty much not pretty. So it would not take this one home to meet mother. Mother does not approve of inappropriate summations inside recurrences, but we have absolutely no problem with this one down here. So that's what I think is really neat about this method, is you can take things that look absolutely awful and turn them into something just beautiful.